Howdy, Aaron Boster here with Ohio Health MS Center. Thought I would take a few minutes today and explain how Alemtuzumab, codenamed Lemtrada, works. I recently sent out a Twitter poll asking folks what they wanted to hear about, and this was by far the most chosen option. So for those of you that voted, thank you very much. For those of you that chose this topic, here you go. Alemtuzumab is a long word. I'm going to write it down so I can break it apart for you. Alemtuzumab. M-A-B means monoclonal antibody. An antibody is something that our own bodies make to fight off infections. And antibodies are like keys. They have very, very specific locks they fit into. So here's an example of a key. This key only fits one lock. And you could try it in a bunch of other doors and it won't work. Monoclonal antibodies are when you create one antibody, for example, one copy of a key, and you make a million of them in a bag, and it's full of this one antibody. That's what monoclonal means. ZU tells us that the engineered antibody is humanized, meaning scientists have taken out as much mouse protein as possible and used as much human material as possible. That's helpful when it's infused into your body because you're less likely to reject it if it's humanized. TU means that this drug was invented to target a tumor. So this drug, Alemtuzumab, was not originally invented to beat up MS. It was originally invented to beat up different kinds of cancers, and that's reflected in the name. Alem has no semantic meaning. I always joke it's someone's name. And so Alemtuzumab is a monoclonal antibody that's been humanized and originally intended to treat tumors. It's an infusible monoclonal antibody. And when you put it in the human body, this special key identifies and binds to a very specific part of the human body. Any cell that expresses something called CD52, so cluster differentiation 52. CD52 is kind of like a hang tag or a sign sticking out from a cell. And if that cell expresses CD52, then alemtuzumab will bind to it, just like a key that fits in a lock. When alemtuzumab binds to a cell with CD52, it targets it for death. And so any cell that's tagged is going to die. To understand what alemtuzumab does, we have to understand which cells express CD52. Adult lymphocytes are the cells that express CD52. Not pluripotent stem cells, not baby cells. These are adult mature lymphocytes, B and T cells. And so when you give someone alemtuzumab, there's a couple things that happen. Very, very rapidly, the monoclonal antibody binds to all the cells with CD52 and kills them all. And it happens very quickly. When we study this, we watch the cell counts just plummet. Interestingly, a month after you've been infused, there's no more antibody in you. You couldn't find alemtuzumab if you searched for it. It's all left. And all of the cell death that's occurred, this targeted immunoablation, has already occurred. And that's the first step in how alemtuzumab works. So step one is, it selectively identifies adult lymphocytes and it knocks them out of play. That's the first step. And that's not the only mechanism. If that was the only way this drug worked, then I would expect it to behave a lot like cyclophosphamide or mitoxantrone or any classic immunosuppressant, which is not the case. Now, the next phase of things is rather interesting because the cell lines slowly grow back. And when I say slowly, I mean slowly. So B cells and monocytes are going to come back in about 3 months. Certain populations of T cells are going to come back in 2.5 years. Certain populations won't fully come back for up to 5 years. But when they come back differently. This is really interesting. In an MS patient, their immune system is altered before we do anything to them. Their natural immune system is a bit off. So when you have T cells, for example, you have T cells that are cops and you have T cells that are sort of, for lack of a better term, robbers. The cops, I'm talking about regulatory cells. And these are T cells that are going to make everyone get in a single file line and walk slowly and no running, and they're going to regulate things. Then you also have inflammatory cells. These are like Th1, Th17 cells. These are aggressive inflammatory cells. And in the MS patient, they have not enough Treg cop cells and way too many inflammatory Th1, Th17 cells. That's the MS patient before we give alemtuzumab. Now, when you give alemtuzumab, you knock down both cell lines because both cell lines express CD52. But when they grow back, something totally weird happens. the regulatory component grows back bigger than it used to be. It grows back more active than it used to be. And so in many ways, the immune system that you're given back after you receive alemtuzumab is different. It behaves differently. That's, in my opinion, why we see a durable effect with this drug. Keep it in mind that we infuse people for 5 days, then we go a full year before we infuse them for 3 days, then we never infuse them again unless they have new disease activity. Now, we've studied people going out 6 years, and what we found is over half of them never needed retreated, and yet the vast majority of them have quiet disease. How's that possible? I think it's possible because after you selectively immunoablate or knock out the adult lymphocytes, you grow them back to be more well-behaved with a larger component of T regulatory cells. That changes the immune response for years and years to come. So there you have it. That's a quick explanation of how alemtuzumab, codenamed Lemtrada, works. I see a question. So the question is this the drug that was looking to be approved into the later this year? No, popcorn. So alemtuzumab, Lemtrada, was FDA approved about 2 years ago. The drug that you're talking about is ocrelizumab. And if you'd like, on a different periscope, I'll explain how that drug works also. Again, my name is Aaron Boster. Thank you for tuning in with Ohio Health MS Center. Today we talked a little bit about how one of the MS therapeutic works, alemtuzumab, codenamed Lemtrada. Have a great rest of your day.